Hello and welcome to Rick Skates. Today, December 31st, 2020, the end of an absolute rubbish year for everybody. I will be continuing on with my werewolf one-ninth bust. I am gone live today. I thought it best to actually post a video instead. But saying that, I just want to say for me and this journey that I am making on YouTube and creating content for you, I want to wish you a happy new year, and I hope that 2021 is much better for everybody globally, and that we can get rid of this pandemic once and for all, because life is just not how it should be. So have a great new year and let's get cracking. Right, so as you can see, I've tarted him up with a load of masking tape because I want to spray his jacket in red, and I don't want to get it across all the stuff that I've already done before. Hopefully I won't get it over the ears and the upper head. Doesn't matter if I get it on the back of the figure, because the hair is going to be black anyway, so I should be able to get around that. But I'm going to airbrush this, because the last time I sprayed something this large, the last time I painted something this large with ordinary acrylics, I couldn't quite get the paint right. So I find it easier that I'm going to spray this, and let's hope it turns out well. It's going to be a red and white jacket, so let's get this done and see how we turn out. I'll eventually paint his stand and make a hole and everything for him to sit on there properly and get him affixed to the base correctly. Okay, let's see how we get on, shall we? See how we do. So I'm using Tamiya's XF7 flat red. put some air on it and dry it off a bit. Because I will go back over the top of this with acrylic anyway. For toning and shading. I know these jackets are normally pure red. Some like maroon red, so I sort of gonna make this slightly maroon red, I think. That's where the grey base helps. Set that and dry out the way for a minute. So yeah, it's been a pretty awful year, I think, for most all across the globe. I also want to thank my subscribers for helping my channel grow, and I look forward to having many more. So thank you, you know who you are. Get rid of 2020, don't we? I think we're going to have a little bit more of the same sort of issues for the first half of, or the first quarter anyway, of 2021. I don't think we're going to be lucky to get rid of it that soon. But if we all pull together, we'll do what our governments are asking us to do to stem it, I'm sure we can all come out the other side much better for it. So let's unmask this wolf boy with his gnarly teeth and continue to get this done. Let's bring your stand back forward again. So yeah, I've got plenty to get on with. Lots to do. I've scratched that already. It's going to be white anyway, and that hair's going to be black. Or a dark brown. And no doubt there'll be other kits I'll be purchasing along the way. I hope that we're going to end up getting back to doing model shows this year, because I certainly miss doing those. Yeah, part of the fun. Obviously, I haven't built much. Done bits and pieces, haven't finished them things. But yeah, strange old year. Let's hope it gets better. Right, being morbid, let me carry on. It's not morbid, is it, really? So, that's that coat down. I actually quite like the look of that once it dries out properly. Unfortunately, I've scratched it slightly there, but I can make changes to that. And a little bit of touching up with some dark red in there for some shadows. And we can get to the white. T-shirt will probably be white. Yeah, probably be white. Grey white. So he's starting to look. Starting to look like a teen wolf. Very angry teen wolf, but he's starting to look like a teen wolf. His gums and that, and his lips. Still think I might have to sort that eye out. Right, let me mix up some. Get some flat red. No, wrong one. I need to do deep recesses. Let's try with our number one. And I want probably might still have enough there with that wet palette, actually. With some burnt red, still pretty wet. Yep, I sorted out my wet palette yesterday. It's back up and running. Right, so got a bit much on here. Let's get some of that off. It's quite wet. I'm getting to the dark areas. Not quite getting in there. I'm just going to need it around the base of the collar. Go over this with either blood letter, which is a glaze, or I think I've got maybe an orange glaze to sort of make it scarlety looking, if you know what I mean. But I need to make sure that my shadows are shadows.
Thank you.
Missed out once on a very nice garage kit bust at a show that I went to. And it was of It. The old Stephen King's Maniacal Clown. £20 it was. Absolutely gorgeous. One of the other guys from my model club purchased it instead and done a crazy job on it. It was a beautiful bust. Well, it wasn't a bust actually, it was a full figure. Balloons, boat, a little paper boat. Yeah, the grate, the sewage drain, the weather. The boat disappeared off down, and the child disappeared off down. Stood about, blimey. 1 foot tall, maybe a foot and a half. I will turn that off in a sec. Don't let it keep rattling on, do we? Excuse me, Mr. Airbrush. Yeah, that was a beautiful kit. Again, that was a garage kit. I was a bit disappointed missing out on that one because that was really, really nice to see. A bit of shadow here. And top this up down here. It's almost like this dark colour is not I might have to add a touch of black. It's not quite I don't know. Might be. Yeah, it sounds like the yobs are out there with their motorbikes. Nothing against motorbikes. All the sensible people that ride them. Around here we have a lot of not very sensible people. Slightly off camera there. I do apologise. A slight rambling. Okay. Need to get back here again. Looks a bit grainy on this video. need to whip up a little bit more burnt red. See if I can find this. Scarlet. I need to probably tint that up a little bit. See if we can get this dark. People in the block and can't walk upstairs without slamming their feet. Society's in a mess. Slightly more dark around there now. Right, so I need to lighten this up. So I need to get on with putting a few coats of probably blood letter on, I think would be the better option. Which means I will go over the entire thing with blood letter. I don't do things the normal way, which is basically to put all the base colours down and then go and start painting everything up. Well, as you can probably tell, I work bit by bit. So I've done the face, then I've done the eyes and the mouth, now I'm doing the main part of the jacket, and then I do the arm separately, and then I do the hair. Yeah, I've never been one to go around and excuse me, do things the normal way. So this blood letter is rather bright, and I need to make quick strokes with it, get it on so it doesn't dry too quickly. So it's going to hopefully brighten the jacket up. Holding by the hair, say a hair by the head. Go and pick some of the pooling out. Need to let that dry a bit. I will be going back on with the blood letter, but I wanted to contrast that I've already done. Looks a lot brighter, doesn't it? We'll put some hair on it and dry it off. So we can fast forward. Let's put some air back in the compressor. dry that off a bit and do some more. Don't know whether to actually... No, I don't think it would be. Alright, let's put some air on here and dry this down. Okay, and it's a bit, go back in again with the old blood letter, but with a smaller brush this time. Let's go in with that hobby brush.
Thank you.
Now I'm going to change from bloodletter. Oh. I'm going to put some Cazandora yellow because I think Fuegan orange is a bit dark. So I'm going to put some Cazandora yellow on.
Thank you.
Drop some more air on there to dry it out. It doesn't look like it on camera, but it's definitely doing what I want it to do. Which is brighten up these areas here. You can see that the shadow coat that I put on, or the darker layer that I put on, is still pretty prevalent in where it needs to be. And yeah, he's smiling, he's happy, he likes his coat. Come on. A bit too wet. Need a couple of coats. Thank you. Well, it's going to need a second coat, that's for sure.
Thank you. Thank you.
Right, I'm going to leave it at that for now. I need to let things dry out properly, even though I've put air down from the airbrush on it, it's not obviously fully cured. That isn't white, by the way, that is Orthowarn grey. I'm using that as a base for the underside of the off-white that I'll use later. Not a bright white, it's quite a nice white, it's not in your face. But he dropped him, threw him on the floor, but there we go, he's definitely coming on. The jacket is not as bright as I wanted it to be, so I'll wait a little bit later on when that's dry and touch it up a bit. When we come back to it in a couple of days, then it'll be a lot better. Still a way to go, obviously, but it's been enjoyable. And if you've got this far to the end of the video, I just want to say thank you very much for watching. If you haven't subscribed, then by all means, please do. Hit the like button. If you want to share the video, by all means, share the video. I want to say thank you very much for making 2020 bearable, considering the circumstances, and helping me to bring my channel on from where it started off over 4 months ago. And last but not least, second to last, I want to thank my current subscribers for making me feel comfortable with putting content out there for you. And the last thing I want to say is I hope you all have a happy new year, and may better things be inbound for all of us for 2021. So please stay safe, enjoy your new year with the people you love, and I'll see you next year. Thank you.